Welcome to this video on preparing your sequences for entry to the GenBank database with Geneious Prime. The GenBank submission tool allows you to upload your sequences directly to GenBank from within Geneious Prime, retaining the annotations and features. The tool allows for simple submissions of a small number of sequences, from messenger RNA, small genomes, organelles, non-coding RNA, and plasmids. It is not available for larger genomes such as bacterial and eukaryotic chromosomes. In this example, we prepare a partial protein coding gene sequence for submission to the GenBank database. The first step involves adding general information about the sequence, including a description, source organism, tissue type, geographic location, sampling dates, etc. All GenBank submissions require this information. Click on the Info tab and the Properties subtab to populate fields. For additional fields, click Add Metadata and choose GenBank Submission. The default GenBank submission fields allow you to add extra information about the specimen from which the sequence was derived, such as country, sequence ID, and collection date. To include other fields, click Edit Metadata Types. Then, click the plus sign, name the field, and specify the input type via the drop-down menu. If desired, use the Constraints option to adjust the settings for the field. Once happy, click OK. You can now populate the new field. Once you're happy with the metadata, click Save. With the metadata entered, you can now format the sequence annotations. GenBank records for protein coding genes require information on the coding region, intron-exon boundaries, and protein translation. This example already has a coding sequence and exon annotations. However, for submission to GenBank, protein coding genes also require a gene annotation. To add this, select the entire gene sequence by pressing Ctrl plus A or Command plus A for Mac, then click Add Annotation. In the new window, enter the gene name and change the type to gene. Gene annotations also require a gene qualifier. To do this, expand the Properties options and click Add. For the name, enter gene with a lowercase g. Qualifier names are case specific. If not typed correctly, they will generate errors during submission. For the value, add the gene name and click OK. You can add optional qualifiers to genes in much the same way. If your sequence represents only a fragment of a gene, you must indicate that the gene annotation represents a partial feature. To do this, expand the interval options and edit the interval in the table. Then, check the appropriate options in the new window to indicate where the sequence is truncated and click OK. With the gene qualifiers set up, you need to add the appropriate qualifiers to the coding sequence and exon annotations. As with the gene annotation, it's best practice to add a gene qualifier to your other annotations. Again, select Add in the Properties window, enter the gene qualifier information and click OK. Coding sequence annotations also require a translation table qualifier representing the genetic code used in translation. Refer to the NCBI Genetic Code Tables page for a list of values. This example uses the standard translation table, so I will use value 1. Another qualifier required for all coding sequence annotations is the codon start. It has a value of 1, 2, or 3, and indicates the offset at which the first complete codon of a coding feature is found relative to the first base, 3 in this example. GenBank will use the information entered in the translation table and codon start qualifiers to create the protein translation for the submission. Lastly, coding sequence annotations also require a product qualifier describing the protein name. If your sequence contains exon annotations, they each require a number qualifier. This qualifier represents the exon number, so if this is the second exon in the gene, enter 2. Then, repeat this process for all other exon annotations in the sequence. As well as adding a number qualifier, it's best practice to also add a gene qualifier to all exons. To add the same gene qualifier to multiple exons, hold down the Control key and select both exon annotations. Then, go to the Edit Annotations window again and add a new entry for the gene qualifier. And that's an overview of adding the required qualifiers to a protein coding gene. You are now ready to submit your sequence to GenBank. To learn more, visit geneious.com.